Good morning. Welcome. It's Carl Briggs, 73 Live. Morning talk. Normally we have night talk. However, I was a bit tied up. Today's topic is selfishness, right? How selfish is that? And one of the things is, as you all know, they're building a lot of facilities in the community to help the homeless situation, right? Like over on Broadway and Manchester, they have a trailer park built for the homeless families, which is a beautiful thing. Also, they have these things called ODR housing to prevent homelessness for mental health patients as well. And the community that's against homelessness, one of them is Timeless Group, hosted by CEO and President Yusuf Wiley and Vice President Cortez Chandler and family. Timeless Group has been in the struggle with fight to not only provide jobs inside of the community, they have also been working toward the goal of preventing homelessness. Now, here's the thing. Inside these communities that they're putting these facilities in, you have a lot of people in the community, communities right here where I come from, that have a problem with that, right? And my thing is, why would you have a problem with somebody preventing someone from being homeless, right? And one of the things that has been said, that I've heard through word of mouth is, oh, they're going to mess up the neighborhood or mess up the community. But let's just say, okay, let's say the facility wasn't on your block. Let's say the facility's on your block, for instance. How does that mess up your community when these guys are actually inside of a program? They're being chaperoned 24 hours a day. They've been watched over 24 hours a day. They've been given the tools that they need to become respondent versus resistant, food, shelter, groups, etc. And let's just take the facilities out of the equation, right? So imagine the facility not on your block, but these same very exact people are homeless running around in your neighborhood. A lot of them are from the neighborhood. Some of them I've seen homeless right in my neighborhood. So now you've given them shelter. I think it would be a better situation because this, like I say, take the facility away and you got this guy out here homeless right here on the block, right? He's being unchaperoned. He has nothing to help him, right? No resources, right? Like I say, food, shelter, clothing, etc., right? And resources. Resources has been the biggest key to solving homelessness, right? Solving the workforce situation where people are out of jobs, right? Unemployment. Unemployment is a big key to this as well. Also, like I said, resources, groups, things of that nature, right? Some of these people really need help and they just haven't been given the chance, right? And so now, how hypocritical is it for you to say, right? And we have what we call, and not to bring religion in this, but we have a lot of God-fearing people inside of our communities. So now, I asked you, what would your God want you to do? What would your God want you to do? Whatever your God is, right? Right? If it's positive, what would your higher power want you to do, right? Oh, the right thing, right? So now let's just take, I come from a rather Christian background. My mom, she was a diehard Christian. Let's just take them for instance, right? Wouldn't you want to solve the homeless problem inside of the community, right? Or would you want them to continue to be homeless and run amok within the community, right? So now, who are we really serving, right? Are we serving humanity or are we serving the devil? Are we serving humanity or are we serving the devil, right? Because serving humanity is serving a higher power, whatever that is in your nature, not to bring religion or offend anyone, anyone's culture. That's not what my show is about. My show is directed to be directed toward change. It's also directed toward a respondent school of thought. And so now I asked you, are you one of the people that's a part of the problem? Because let's just say you don't want these people living in your community. They still live in your community. They're just homeless. So with that said, let's get in the fight like Timeless, the Timeless group, right? Shout out to Youssef, Cortez, and the family. Keep doing what you're doing. It's an unselfish gesture. It's rewarding to see that people really actually care. Homelessness is at a 61% spike, the highest in the nation. We're talking right here in the United States of America, especially in Los Angeles. It's like a third world country. You know, you got people sleeping all under the bridges, you know, just camping out on the blocks, you know, tents are everywhere. You see children, whole families, right? So I too have family members who suffer from homelessness, right? And who have suffered from homelessness, right? And so if you one of the people that believe in your mind that building these facilities will hurt your community, shame on you.